Hi guys, welcome back. I'm Ian Laspina. Today we're going to talk about the Visored Barbute. Is it historical? Hey guys, welcome back. So today I want to start kind of an open-ended discussion on what I like to call the Franken-Armors. And what I mean by that are armors that were cobbled together like the Frankenstein's monster. In the 19th century, you had a lot of Victorian medievalists who took unrelated components of historical armor and just kind of put them together. Even into the 20th century, you had people like Bashford Dean who did something similar. And what it's led to is a lot of pieces of armor that were on display or are currently on display that make people think that these are historical medieval armors. They end up getting copied and reproduced, when in fact they're copying basically compromised armors that in some cases aren't even functional. So today, to start that off, I want to start with the Visored Barbute from the Musée de l'Armée in Paris. This particular helmet has come up a lot lately, which is why I wanted to start with that one. I've gotten, I think, three PMs about it in the last 2 weeks. It's come up a bunch on Facebook and some discussion forums and things like that, and hopefully we can help lay this one to rest. So this is the helmet I'm talking about. If you've seen photos of it, these are probably the photos that you have seen of it. It's a pretty striking looking helmet. It's a really, you know, it's a cool looking helmet. It's aesthetically pleasing. It's pretty intimidating looking. It's, you know, it's a mean looking helmet. It's cool. But the problem is it is a compromised helmet. The visor and the skull were put together in the 19th century from two historical pieces that were not associated. Let's take a look. So when you look under the visor, you can see that it's a barbute, and that should make you ask some questions. So let's take a look at this thing individually, component by component. So we got the skull and the visor. So let's take a look at the skull. So stylistically, the skull is a pretty typical mid-15th century Italian barbute. Now, the thing about barbutes is they're basically a helmet that was designed to not require a visor. The whole reason that they have such, the helmet comes down so far and protects so much of the face with just that narrow opening for the mouth and the eyes is because the helmet was designed to be worn without a visor in the first place. We have a lot of surviving barbutes, and none of them have visors. None of them have the holes for visor pivots. This one's kind of unique in that it's the only surviving barbute that seems to have an associated visor. And that makes sense because the barbute is a style of helmet that doesn't need a visor. If you wanted something with more protection, then something like the contemporary Errant would have been a better choice. Now, the other part that pretty convincingly dates this helmet to the mid-15th century are the maker's marks. So let's look at the back of the helmet, and we can see here that it has two identical maker's marks stamped on either side of the back of the skull. But that is the specific maker's mark of the Massalia workshop of Milan, which would again date this helmet to the mid-15th century based on the style, based on the maker's mark, because that's when the workshop was active. Now, the other possibility is that the maker's marks are a forgery. Now, if they are a forgery, one, why would you do that? Well, having the Massalia maker's mark on the back of your armor makes that armor a whole heck of a lot more valuable because it's a very famous workshop. But the other part is if these are forgeries, then it lends credence to the idea that this skull has been compromised in some way. If the maker's marks are in fact authentic, then it pretty convincingly dates the helmet to the 15th century, like we discussed earlier. Now let's take a look at the visor. Is the visor historical in shape? Yes, but the problem is that keeping in mind that this is a 15th century style helmet, that style of visor dates to the second half of the 14th century. When we look at late 14th century Italian artwork, this visor is not all that uncommon. It appears pretty frequently. The problem is, not only is it a 14th century visor with a little spillover into the early 15th century, but this style of visor exclusively appears on bassinets, not barbutes. So when we look at the artwork, we see what otherwise would be a pretty standard bassinet in shape with its aventail and everything we expect to see on a bassinet. But instead of the international houndskull style visor, we see this style of visor instead. So what about the fit? You know, when we look at the actual visor and skull together, they look like they fit really well. Well, the collectors and museums would much rather have a complete helmet rather than a skull and a disassociated visor that don't match. So they kind of knew what people wanted and they gave them what they wanted. That's why we see a lot of mismatched visors on bassinets, on a lot of surviving bassinets that were never intended to go together, because people had the desire to have a complete helmet. And then you reshape the metal, you attach them as best you can, and you polish them to match, and the result is modern history. So what is the current status of this helmet? As far as I know, the helmet was on display for a while without its visor. The visor was the visor and the helmet were separated at the museum, and then the helmet was on display by itself. I don't know what the current status of the helmet is. I've seen reports that it was in storage. I don't know how current that is or if it's currently on display just as the helmet again. I've never been to the Musée de l'Armée, so I can't say for sure. But the problem is the damage is already done. The photographs of the helmet with the visor have been passed around so frequently that people have used them for quite a long time as a basis for documenting a visored barbute, when in fact it's kind of a Franken barbute. So if you are interested in a reproduction or incorporating some of the stylistic elements of that helmet into your kit, the visor really belongs in a late 14th century Italian kit on a late 14th century Italian bassinet. Here's a great example of what one of those helmets may have looked like historically. This is a reproduction by Augusto Boer Brandt of a bassinet with that style of helmet. Again, you can see that it's a typical bassinet shape. It has vervails for the attachment of the aventail, and then in place of the international houndskull style visor, it has this style of Italian visor instead. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hopefully this kind of dispels some of the myths out there about the visored barbute and that helmet in particular. If you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up, like, subscribe if you haven't already, share it with your friends, and special thank you to my patrons on Patreon who have helped to support the channel. I'm very grateful for that decision. And until next time, thank you for watching. Bye.